big fights with guys that you know from the amateurs, I'm sure. Rolando Romero, Gervonta Davis, and then Haney Cambosis. Let's start with Tank and Rowley. We're just a couple days away. What do you think?
Tank all day.
Why?
I think Rowley just leaves his chin out too like wide open. I think he's too wide. To beat Tank, you really have to be like a smart fighter. You have to have high IQ. I don't think Rowley is a high IQ fighter. He's just going in and trying to kill someone, trying to take their head off.
Does he have a chance?
That's not going to work.
He has power.
I mean,
he's in shape.
In boxing, there's always a chance. I think that he could, you know, if Tank runs into something, then Tank could go down. But I don't think Tank will run into something. I think Tank knows better.
So what's your prediction?
I think Tank by TKO or Tank by stoppage.
Then, you know Haney since you were kids, since he was eight. What do you think about his fight with Cambosis?
I got Devin. I think...
Even with his dad not being there?
Yeah, I feel like it is going to affect him, but I feel like Devin is just way too hungry right now. I feel like he just wants all those belts. And I feel like he's the type of fighter to beat Cambosis. To beat Cambosis, you have to be a boxer, a good boxer. Teofimo, he's a good boxer, but he didn't get the job done that night. I feel like Devin will.
I think Teofimo had a lot of medical issues going into the fight. He still fought, and fans, at the end of the day, if Haney loses and he says, I lost because my dad wasn't there, nobody's going to care. Nobody cares, right?
Nah, I feel like Devin's going to take the fight.
We'll see. What's, 12 days away, whatever it is?
Yeah, we're like 11 days away.
You going to go to Australia for it?
I got to stay out.
Oh, yeah, we're going to fly to Australia on private jet. Yeah.
Why not? Twice. How's BlueFase doing? You guys are in camp, working hard?
Yeah, he's doing good. He's actually about to come in right now.
Does he have any fight coming up?
We're hoping somewhere in July. He's looking better.
His name is circulating. Different gyms that I go to, they mention him as someone they're going to fight, like a few people.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, so he's getting people's attention.
Yeah, we're trying to, we're trying to get better. We're trying to get him out of, you know, he came in thinking, like, this is like a street fight and everything, and I had to change it up.
It's an art. It's a fight, but it's an art.
Yeah,
you have to learn.
Make a lot of improvements to him, but...
But he is improving, absolutely.
We're getting it done.
What have you learned about him that you didn't know before?
I honestly thought, like, he was just, like, one of these, like, cocky celebrities, like, what you would really think about him, but...
Super humble, chill, regular dude.
In reality, it's the complete opposite.
Just really famous and really rich.
Yeah, we go running together, we hang out, we go eat together, so...
Does he get mobbed when people recognize him in places?
When he goes out? Yeah, all the time.
What was it like to go to a show where you performed in front of like 60,000 people?
It was crazy. The energy was unreal.
Did you grab the mic and try to rap yourself?
Nah, hell no.
Why did you write a song and try?
I can't rap for shit.
Can you rap?
Of course I rap.
Have your dad.
Why you ask me questions? I rap all day. That's what I do.
But it's a great thing.
Armenian, on Russian, on Hebrew, on Ukrainian, on any language.
How did you and him link up? How did he end up in the gym? What happened?
So we had a mutual friend. And then that mutual friend is best friends with his manager. And
keep it 100.
WAG 100.
WAG 100. Yeah.
And he was best friends with him. And then we had a meeting one day, and I was like, all right, when are you ready to get started? He's like, let's train right now. And he was like in Balenciagas and shit.
Yeah, I know. No, he's very. He just walks in with jeans on. He'll train.
All jewelry, like, you know, has a bunch of jewelry.
Laced up.
And I was like, you sure you want to go right now? He's like, yeah, let's go right now. I was like, all right, bet. So, ever since then.
That's cool.
The car's so expensive, look how key is cheap. My Jeep is like more expensive key, more luxury.
David, tell everybody where to follow you.
On Instagram, David Kaminsky with two Y's.
Kaminsky Boxing.
Kaminsky Boxing. And what are the hours you're told? If people want to come train, they want to get in shape, they want to lose weight, they want to know how to fight.
Better do not come, that's the way.
9 to 9, right? 9 to 9. 9 to 9. What does it cost to join? 50?
$50.
That's very affordable. It's not expensive. A lot of gyms are very... I want to learn MMA. 200, 300, 400, 500.
Classes, yeah.
Yeah, classes.
Classes. 150.
Oh, classes 150.
Just enjoy the gym like she does or some like training camp. And like $50.
That's cool.
You hit the bags and just... the rule number one, don't be on my way. That's it.
Just get out of your way. Don't bother you.
Get on my way. That's it. If I'm not trained, just stay.
Your dad has always been so sociable?
Unsocial.
A lot of people in boxing are antisocial. A lot of fighters, a lot of trainers.
I don't know, they're probably all gay. Everybody's social. They like to talk to each other. Look at the boxing gym, everybody talks. Nobody trains, everybody.
So you want them to train, not to talk?
Yeah, everybody talks, nobody trains.
All right, stay tuned. Tony Kaminsky, keeping it 100. Elisek back reporting.